an Icelandic saga by Giolo. In June of 1967, Emmett Williams, James Upham, and Dorothy Iannone Upham sailed from New York City on the Gullfoss, an Icelandic freighter bound for Reykjavik. Dorothy, intent on embellishing the cocktail hour, bought the following.
And now at 10 a.m., many red wines further, and even considering making my tinned lobster diables at this amazing hour, I thank God for art.
Art is a world that I have created, which never lets me down, a world to which I can return again and again, and smile and be immortal.
Synopsis. Emmett, the friend of Dieter, Dorothy and her husband James, the friends of Emmett have sailed on a freighter from New York to Reykjavik. The long ocean voyage has led to confrontations, especially between Dorothy and James. The only other passengers have been Saga, an Icelandic boy, and his mother. Saga has taken part in the card games played by Dorothy, Emmett and James, and has, in retrospect, been recognized as Cupid. Dieter meets the ship with a very fresh fish under his arm, and he and Dorothy, strangers until that moment, smile deeply at each other.
Honoring the past and embracing the future, she was filled with love for everyone.
Forward. When the Icelandic saga was begun somewhere in a tree, the events described were a mere 11 years distant. Its middle installment, 2006, was written in that 50 years. No circumstance and inclination combined to elicit the closing chapter of that exactly 18-year-old decisive adventure, that journey which it seems to have made all other journeys possible. I write the end of this story with love and thanks to all the participants, but especially to James Upham and to Dieter Roth.
So much of this story has already been published that a satisfying synopsis will take many pages. Perhaps it would be enough to say that the Icelandic saga relates the story of how in 1967 Dieter plus Dorothy met in Reykjavik, fell in love, and came together.
She can imagine that James was relieved to see the sun rise on their last day in Reykjavik, and that finally they could fly back to New York and leave this Dieter Holt forever behind, never suspecting that she and Dieter had already declared their readiness to come together.
But James immediately gathered up his mail and sat reading it on the toilet for 20 minutes, while Dorothy, ignoring the cat's pleas for food and for maybe more than perfunctory greetings, paced the floor, waiting for James' reappearance.
Socrates, no show, undeterred Dorothy.
Bills.
Dress shop, tailor, laundry, art supplies, hairdresser, 8th Street bookshop.
Buy a ticket.
Air freight, how much?
A bedroom.
Emmett's things to Maryland, send Saga her stuff.
Buy.
Record player, Saga books, suspenders, scotch, cigarettes, contraceptive pills, mascara, toothpaste, suitcases.
She believes that her permanent presence at his site would have been inappropriate to the fulfillment of his life's design, something which she, no doubt, has long ago also realized. She wishes happiness and long life to him and to his family.
I don't remember that she was to be daunted, and she continued her way to Dieter's door.
Exactly 1 week before, she and Emmett and her husband had first arrived in Reykjavik. Now she stood here alone, a 33-year-old woman who had in that short period changed her life radically. Knocking on the door of the little former laundry where her love lived. I doubt that she had ever been in a more vulnerable position than she was during those seconds when she stood beside her suitcases and waited for someone to answer the door.
And Dieter came and opened the door. He invited me in and the life I had chosen began. He led me through the back so that I could meet Emmett. They had not come to fetch me, it seemed, because the airlines had told them that my name was not on the passenger list. And then, a free woman, Dorothy lay down on the bed with Dieter, that free man, and they began, at last with delight and with wonder, their 7 years in grace, as well as a spiritual connection which does not permit itself to be lost.
The end of the Icelandic Saga.